Hello everyone, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
I have to start by reading today's psalm because I think it could have been written for us today. And I remember commenting on that before when this was the psalm set for the day, but it still holds true. As I read it, it may help you to see it as a prayer of gratitude to God for being with us through this pandemic, and a request now for the restoration of both our economy and individual people's lives. So here it is, Psalm 126. When the Lord brought back the captives to Zion, we were like men who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy." Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like streams in the Negev. Those who sow in tears will reap with songs of joy. He who goes out weeping, carrying seed to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with him. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord has done great things for us too, and we should be filled with joy. We're not entirely out of the woods now. We've not all got back to Jerusalem, but we are on the way. We also pray for God to restore our fortunes. We too may have worked on through our tears as we went through the pandemic, but we too look forward to a restoration of our economy. I also want to reflect on the gospel reading. So listen to the good news proclaimed in Luke's gospel, chapter 8, reading verses 16 to 18.
Glory to Christ our Saviour.
No one lights a lamp and hides it in a jar or puts it under a bed. Instead, he puts it on a stand so that those who come in can see the light. For there is nothing hidden that will not be disclosed, and nothing concealed that will not be known or brought out into the open. Therefore, consider carefully how you listen. Whoever has will be given more. Whoever does not have, even what he thinks he has, will be taken from him. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
We can't understand this little parable unless we look at what comes before it. And that is the parable of the sower and its explanation. We learn that that parable is about how people receive the gospel news differently. Jesus speaks about the way various soils or hearts receive the seed, which is his word, in different ways. With that in mind, we can see here that Jesus is speaking about how we listen to the word and what we do with it. Jesus is the light of the world, and all of us who receive him are touched by this light and should shine it out for others to see. If we have received Jesus into our lives, if we have been good hearers of his word, then that will be seen in the way that we live our lives and in the way that we share this word with others, and both are necessary. Who or what is a good hearer of the word? It's certainly not enough just to read the Bible or to listen to a sermon. It is to allow the word to transform or change us. It has to make a difference in our lives. Going back to the language of the original parable, our lives should look different if we have fertile soil in our hearts and the seeds can germinate and grow. We will begin to bear fruit. We will live the life that Jesus wants us to live. But equally, we should want to share this with others. As I said before, both are necessary. And you know, so often we fail to listen properly, either to God's word or to other people. And so I think that listening is a skill that we need to practice. Jesus warns the disciples and us to be careful about how they and we hear the word. We will be held responsible for what we do with it, for how we live it out, for how we share it with others. Notice that Jesus adds another reason to be careful how we hear. It's that if we really listen to God's word, allow it to take root in our hearts and change us, then we will be given even more truth. We will have even more understanding of his word. We will grow and bear more fruit. But going back to the original parable, if the word falls on rocky ground or among thorns, even the little bit of understanding that the person originally had will just dissipate. Let us really learn to listen to God's word, to allow it to change us, to allow the light of the world, Jesus, to shine out through us. And let us share this light with others. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we ask you to help us really listen to your word. Through the work of your Spirit, may it change us to become more like your Son, Jesus. May we faithfully live it out, and so may we come to know you more closely. We also know, Lord, that we do not always listen carefully to what others are saying to us. Help us to become more sensitive to the words of others. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us pray the prayer for South Africa together. Lord, grant us a vision for our land, a land of justice where none shall prey on others, a land of plenty where poverty shall cease to fester, a land of work where all can be employed, a land of openness where all are accepted as equal, a land of healing, where hatred and racial prejudice exist no more, a land of peace, which is free of violence, and bring this vision to fruition for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We pray for Africa. God bless Africa. Guard our leaders. Guide our leaders. Second time I've said that wrong. Guard our children and give us peace through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, all for whom you pray and whom you love, now and always. Amen. And so, go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. Stay safe, everybody. Keep well and lots of love. Goodbye.
Speak, O Lord, as we come. receive the food of your holy word. Take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. Teach us, Lord, full obedience, holy reverence, true humility. Test our thoughts and our attitudes in the radiance of your purity. Cause our faith to rise, cause our eyes to see your majestic love and authority. Words of power that can never fail, let the truth prevail over unbelief. And by grace we'll stand on your promises, and by faith we'll walk as you walk with us. Speak.